So here's the dream that I had last night here for you, and I'm just going to mention it briefly. The dream that God gave me last night, I showed up in what felt like a Jurassic Park attractional theater, if you will. Now, if that offends you and you think Jurassic Park is demonic, I'm sorry. Okay, how many of you know that movie, Jurassic Park, right? So they stream you in and they have all sorts of different dinosaurs and different attractions there. But when I looked up and looked at the sign, it said the Charismatic Zoo. So I'm in some kind of theme park that feels like I'm in Jurassic Park. And I look up at the sign and it says the Charismatic Zoo. And what I found very interesting was it was like over here in this cage was a fire tunnel exhibit. And you could go through and they would teach you the fire tunnel, okay? And over here in this cage, they were talking to you about how to, it was like a quick access pass to become an apostle. And you could even, if you had more money, you could kind of quick circuit your way into a platform, that kind of feel. Now, I'm in the dream bent over feeling gross. I'm feeling like something is seriously off in the spirit here at the Charismatic Zoo. And there's all sorts of opportunities, and there's laughter, there's cotton candy, there's popcorn. It's a very fun, exciting, exuberant kind of, you know, come one, come all. And in the dream, I'm walking through and I see this little exhibit that it wasn't shiny. It wasn't glamorous, but I felt drawn toward it. And so I make my way over to this area and I realize, like, you have to go through this passageway to get there. And so I walk down this passageway and there's a woman that's standing at the door. And she says, "Hey, Jeremiah, I'm here and what we do is Risen Nation tours." And I said, "Okay, I'll do that. I haven't done anything in the, I'll do the Risen Nation tour." In this dream, this door opens up, and it is the most colorful, vibrant, angelic, celestial. It felt like heaven. And I'm walking down this path, and the Holy Spirit says to me, "It's the road to Emmaus." And he says to me, "Jeremiah, I've not called Risen Nation to be a part of the Charismatic Zoo. I've called Risen Nation to a different kind of path. It's called the Road to Emmaus." And if you remember Luke 24, on the road to Emmaus, Jesus, the risen Lord, Risen Nation, begins to reveal himself to them through the law, through the Psalms, through the prophets. And I believe that God has destined this body of believers to walk down the road of Emmaus. And ultimately, what God is after here is a fellowship of burning hearts. He's after a gathering of men and women that just want Jesus. And you might even be here today and you've tried the charismatic soup and you've had a little of that and a little of this. But I believe that God is inviting this generation and he's inviting this body of believers down an ancient path that's not full of glitter and gold and glamour, but it is full of Jesus. And so I'm going to pray today as we dive in the Word of God. And if you have a yes in your heart, Lord, we just want you. It's 3:19, March 19th. I just couldn't get away from Acts 3:19 and Revelation 3:19, which says, repent. What if we need to repent for the way we've been doing church? One of the false prophets going to stop prophesying when we stop paying them. It's just amazing how quickly we go after the church and her leaders without realizing we've paved their way to the top. What if today is about something breaking in the spirit realm? What if today is about pure and simple-hearted devotion to Jesus? What if this is about, Lord, I'm sorry for the things I've made it. But it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I know that this is a house for him. I know that you all have set your face towards Psalm 132, but that will be tested in the days ahead. Whether you're really here for Jesus, whether you're really committed to walk with him, will always be tested as we do God's church, God's way. Will you pray with me? God, I pray, Holy Spirit, that you would release a spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of who you are as we open up your word today. Lord, I pray that light would flood our hearts. Lord, I pray that you would raise up a strong apostolic team in this place. Lord, I pray for the greatest training and equipping this generation has ever seen. Lord, I pray that you would set religious captives free in America. Lord, I pray that you would break the chains of religious bondage that has left your people with their teeth rotting out and their bellies full of everything but you. Lord, we say no to the charismatic zoo today, and we say yes to the road called Emmaus. In Jesus' name, amen.